In the previous section, we set up our first React project using Create React app and saw some of the features that it offers us, which can help improve the developer experience. In this section, we are going to build and render Hello World heading onto the web page using React library. I have this intro app project already opened inside my Atom editor now. The very first thing that I'm going to do is to select all these files and delete them so that we'll be starting our application from a clean slate. Okay, now let's create a new index.js file inside our src directory, which will serve as a starting point of our application. Okay, we can start writing some React code over here to render Hello World heading onto the web page. To start with, if I have to do it in HTML, then I would write h1 with content Hello World like this. Let's put it in comments. Okay, in React, if I have to do the same thing, then what we need to do is we need to create a React element of type h1 with content or children as Hello World that will eventually spit out the heading onto the web page. Let's write it in comments. In React, if we want to do the same thing, we first need to create a React element of type h1 with content Hello World, which will eventually spit out our heading onto the web page. Fine. So how to create our React element then? React offers us the method by name createElement. Using that createElement method, we can create React elements of any type. Now in our case, we are going to create an element of type h1. So I'm gonna write var app equal to react.createElement. Since we want to create an h1 html element, I'm just gonna pass h1 string as its first argument. As a second argument, we can give some attributes or properties that are to be applied over the element, like CSS class name, ID, etc. We don't need to introduce any attributes as of now, so simply pass null as its second argument. And as our third argument, it expects the children that will be nested inside the created element, that is inside our h1 tag. So in our case, we expect it to contain Hello World, so simply pass Hello World text as its third argument. Okay, through the createElement method call here, React creates a React element of type h1 with no attributes or properties and content or children as Hello World, and finally assigns it to our app variable over here on the left hand side. ReactElement is nothing but a JavaScript object containing information about the element that has to be displayed on the web page. You can think of ReactElement as a lightweight object representation of what's going to be appeared on the or rendered on the web page. You might have noticed that we are using React here, but so far we didn't tell our index.js file to import React from React package. To do that, we are going to use common JS module syntax. We will look at new standard module syntax after covering ES6 section. To import React from React library, I'm going to say right over at the top var react equal to require and the name of the package in quotes, which is React. Okay. Next thing is, we need to somehow tell React to take this React element app and display it on the web page using DOM. Let's just put it in comments. We need to somehow tell React to take our React element, which is app, and display it on the web page using DOM. Okay, and the way we do that is we say react DOM.render and pass the React element, which is in our case app, to it as its argument. Okay, again, in order to use React DOM in our code, we need to import React DOM from React DOM package. So I'm gonna import it just like I did for React package. I'm gonna write var react-dom equal to require and the name of the package, which is react-dom in quotes, like this. Fine. Let's just save it. You might have noticed that we are using two libraries, React and ReactDOM. And you might be wondering why React and ReactDOM are two separate packages instead of one. And that's a perfectly valid question to ask. Not very long ago, React used to contain ReactDOM or DOM part of React as well. But then React concept of building composable user interfaces turned out to be a really good idea. And soon enough, library authors at Facebook realized that the ideas of React can be extended beyond the web browsers. And React can also be used for other platforms like native mobile apps to build user interfaces. With the advent of React Native, which is used to write apps for Android and iOS, the library authors decided to separate DOM part or web part of library from React and moved it out to a new library by name ReactDOM. So core React library that we imported on the first line knows how to create components as well as to compose them and some other stuff. It contains code that is independent of platform over which the components will get rendered on. And renderers like ReactDOM and React Native are responsible for making changes in the environment to render UI on the corresponding platform. In recent times, React way of building UI components has been adopted over several different platforms like native Android and iOS apps, desktop apps, TV apps, virtual reality apps, and so on. With ReactDOM, we are saying that we want to render UI on the DOM available on the browsers, as opposed to these platforms like native mobile apps, etc. Concisely, React helps in building views or components for the UI, whereas ReactDOM helps to render or display those onto the DOM. So to render components on the browser, we use the library ReactDOM, but not React. Things will be clear when we start building applications in React. Other question that might come to your mind is, we didn't install or fetch any libraries or packages. Then how did we get these packages like React and ReactDOM? The answer is, when we create a project using Create React app, it installs some basic packages that are needed to develop our React application. React as well as ReactDOM packages are among them. Now that we know what React and ReactDOM are and what purposes they solve, let's try this code out on the browser and see if it works. And we get an error on the console saying target container is not a DOM element. In the next section, we'll try to understand the error message and work to resolve it. Alright, let's keep going.